Wolves finally got the chance to celebrate their championship title win in style after drawing with Sheffield Wednesday. Nuno Espirito Santo's side got their hands on the championship trophy for the first time on Saturday afternoon as they celebrated in front of their jubilant fans at the Molineux. After winning the league with an emphatic 4-0 victory over Bolton in their previous game, they had to wait a whole week to fully celebrate their impressive title win. And Wolves boss Santo admitted it was fantastic to get his hands on the trophy following his side's 0-0 home draw against Sheffield Wednesday. Nuno said, "It is a special day. A fantastic day. When you get something that is material and you can hold on to that is when you feel you are champions. I think we were the better team in the competition, more consistent, and we deserved it after the hard work of the boys. It is a day that I will always remember. All the support throughout the season here at Molineux and all the stadiums has been fantastic. But especially today after the game had finished, they celebrated with us. It was a fantastic day for us in our memory." Meanwhile, Cardiff took a huge step towards automatic promotion from the Championship on Saturday as captain Sean Morrison scored a double to fire his side to a 2-0 victory at Hull. The centre-back scored a goal in either half as the Bluebirds overcame a nervy start to set up a potential promotion party when relegation threatened Reading visit next Sunday. Fulham reclaimed second spot with a come-from-behind win over Sunderland on Friday night, but they are a point behind heading into their last game at struggling Birmingham. Derby missed the opportunity to secure their playoff place as Aston Villa hit back to claim a 1-1 draw. Cameron Jerome put the Rams in front early on, but Lewis Graben equalised 6 minutes from time. The result ended Villa's slim automatic promotion hopes, while Derby will have a keen eye on the evening game between 5th-placed Middlesbrough and Millwall, who are 3 points adrift of both teams. Preston are 2 points off the top six after Alan Brown's second-half goal gave Alex Neil's side a 1-0 win at Sheffield United, whose own playoff hopes are over. Burton made it 3 straight wins against relegation rivals Bolton, but Nigel Clough's side must get a result at Preston on the final day after Barnsley beat Brentford 2-0 to move out of the drop zone by virtue of their vastly superior goal difference. Goals in either half from Kiefer Moore and Oliver McBurnie gave the Reds a crucial victory that left their fate in their own hands and ended Brentford's playoff bid. Burton did their bit with a 2-0 triumph courtesy of first-half strikes from Hope Hackman and Lucas Akins, a result that left Bolton, who began the day outside the bottom three, a point from safety. Birmingham and Reading face an anxious week after both sides suffered defeats that left them 2 points above the drop zone. Che Adams put Birmingham ahead at QPR, but the hosts hit back to claim a 3-1 win thanks to goals from Bright Osai Samuel, Ilias Chair, and Matt Smith. Martin Waghorn, Jordan Spence, Freddie Sears and Callum Connolly all netted in the final 20 minutes as Ipswich hammered Reading 4-0. Wes Houlihan enjoyed a dream send-off as he engineered a 2-1 comeback win over Leeds on his final appearance for Norwich. The 35-year-old midfielder brought the curtain down on a 10-year spell at Carrow Road by cancelling out Calvin Phillips' opener before Josh Murphy completed the turnaround.